Hi everyone, I'm Jessica Bowman, and most people know me as Miss Jess. I'm a children's librarian at Green Township. I'm going to be talking a little bit about engineering today, but don't get too scared because it's really simple terms and these are very simple things that you can do at home. So we are going to talk about shape strength, and this is something I like to call my super simple strength shape test. So you'll need your three pieces of paper, some tape, and some books. And these are books I just ran around and grabbed. So our first shape we're gonna make is a circle. And you're gonna take your paper and you're simply going to fold it into a circle. And then we're gonna take some tape. Now I like to take a few pieces of tape and set them on the edge of my workstation. That just makes it a little bit easier. You by no means have to use a lot of tape, but if you want to experiment, you can try making shapes with more tape or less tape. It just kind of depends. So I'm going to tape my circle. And the other awesome thing about this experiment is you can practice rolling your shapes or making your shapes with the short end of the paper or the long end of the paper. So the next shape I'm going to make is a triangle. So you're going to fold your paper 1, 2, 3 times and leave a little bit at the end. That's for your tape, okay? So before I get started, I'm going to peel my tape. I'm only going to use 2 pieces today. And then I'm going to fold my paper. Now, your folds don't have to be exact, but if your child is older, this is a great way to practice measuring. They could measure equal parts of the paper. So my paper is folded and it looks like a triangle. So I'm gonna put my tape on there. And there is my triangle. And then my last piece of paper is a square. Now this one's a little bit more difficult because you need, how many sides does a square have? 4, very good. So you wanna make sure that when you fold your paper, you have 1, 2, 3, 4 folds with a little bit at the end, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and fold my paper. And again, this is a great opportunity if you have older children to practice measuring skills so they can practice measuring equal lengths on their paper. So I'm gonna pull my tape off. And then I'm going to make my square. All right, so I'm gonna tape it there, like so. And tape it there, like so. So there are my three shapes. We have the square, the circle, and our triangle. And before you try to test how strong the shapes are, ask your child, what shape do they think is gonna be strongest? Help them make predictions or guesses as to what might happen when they stack the books, okay? So once you have your shapes ready, you're just gonna take a shape and you're gonna start with one book at a time, okay? And this is also a great time to practice counting with your little one if they're just starting to learn how to count. So we have one book, we have two books. Oh, do you see how it wobbled? 3, oh my goodness. 4. 4 books was too many for our circle shape. Let's try our square. So 1 book. Oh, it's already rolling. 2. It only made 1.5. Can you believe that? So our square is out. Let's try our triangle. Okay, 1 book. Triangle. 1 book already? Oh my goodness, my paper must be weak. 1 book. 2 books. Oh, oh, look at that. Now, this is a good time to talk about why our triangle might have failed, because sometimes triangles really should not fail. They're the strongest shape. That's why you see them a lot of bridges. But it could be the paper I'm using. It could be the way I taped it, maybe. So this is a good chance to practice why asking questions and asking why things might have not have worked out. And also have fun. Science is about learning and trying different things over and over. You don't have to use any sort of special paper. You might want to practice. Maybe use some computer paper, use some construction paper. Different weighted paper might make a difference. Mine's just flimsy computer paper. All right, we're moving on to our second very super simple experiment. This is what I call Play-Doh construction. If you don't have Play-Doh, there are recipes online through Pinterest that you can make your own, which might be fun with your little ones to get messy. The other thing you can use is marshmallows or gummy candies. I have Play-Doh today. So this is great for both the young kids and the older kids. For the young kids, what I like to do is give them a bit of Play-Doh. And this is an exercise that really works on those fine motor skills and hand-eye coordination. So you're gonna take a ball of Play-Doh, you're gonna stick it on that table. And I'm using spaghetti today. You're gonna stick a thing of spaghetti in there. You can take any sort of cereal that has a hole in it. I'm using Cheerios today. That's what we had in my house. And for the little ones, they're gonna practice threading the Cheerio onto the spaghetti. If they eat a few, that's okay too. So if your little one is maybe starting to learn their numbers, you can practice again with the counting. So how many Cheerios did we put on there? 1, 2, 3 Cheerios. This is also a really good exercise in subtraction. If your child's starting kindergarten, first grade, or second grade, working on those addition and subtraction math skills. So I would say, I have 3 Cheerios. If I add 2 more Cheerios, how many Cheerios is that? So 3, 4, 5 Cheerios. Now to make it a little more challenging for your older kids, you can ask them, can you make a 3D shape? So what they're gonna do is they're gonna take their little bit of Play-Doh and they're gonna roll it up. We're gonna make a square, a cube. So first I'm gonna build the base of my cube, which is what shape? You guessed it, a square. And you're probably thinking, what makes it a cube? And you'll see in just a moment. All right, so there's my little Play-Doh square. Now, a cube has 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4 sides. So I need some more Play-Doh here. Marshmallows are fun too, because then you can eat them at the end. But I didn't have any marshmallows in my house, so. You're gonna stick it on the end there. It might fall over, but that's okay. This is also a great way to play with different, like less is more exercises. So you can use less Play-Doh and see what happens. You can use more Play-Doh and see what happens. Whoops. And once you get all your sides up, it'll be a little bit more stable. The Play-Doh's a little heavier than marshmallows, so you'll notice a bit more of your movement than if you use marshmallows. And there is your cube. Now from here, you can ask your older child, can you make a bridge? Can you make a tower? Can you make a house? And you're only using spaghetti, Play-Doh, and their imagination. So our very last experiment is like as simple as it can be. And I call this block construction. And basically all you're doing is you're gonna go around your house, run around the house and find anything that is a block or can be used as a block. Maybe you have a bunch of packing boxes. Maybe you have a bunch of old delivery boxes or empty cereal boxes, and you can use those, and those can be your billing blocks. Or if you're like me, you have a bunch of blocks all over your house, and you can just use all of those. So I've just pulled some blocks today for my house. And Lego has some really awesome free activities you can find through Pinterest. And these activities will give your child prompts. So it'll say, can you build a house? Can you build a boat? Can you build a car? And the thing I like about these prompts is you can really use them with any sort of block form. So you can use them with wooden blocks, you can use them with bristle blocks, you can use them with the teeny tiny Legos. So today I am going to build a tower. So for the base of my tower, I'm going to use three yellow blocks. One, two, three. And this is another activity. Again, you can make it as difficult or as easy as you want, depending on the age of your child. I have a toddler, so we do a lot of counting and we do a lot of color recognition. So the base of my tower is going to be three yellow blocks. And then I'm going to look for blue. My base is going to be blue. And this is a really good exercise in problem solving as you build. So I don't have another three light blue like this guy. So instead, I'm going to take one dark blue and one single dark blue to finish off my tower there. Now it's getting a little harder because I'm running out of blocks. That's the other thing. You can take a certain number of pile of blocks and say this is what they have to build with. It does not have to be hard. I really encourage parents to check out Pinterest. There's a lot of great material on there. I am not a spokesperson for Pinterest. I just get a lot of ideas from there. All right, oh, well that's not working. Why isn't that going down? I think my block is different. So now my tower is starting to look a little wonky. See that? Oh boy, I don't know. And you can start counting. At this point, you can start saying, okay, so maybe my tower, so these two blocks are not the same as these. Maybe I take them off. How many blocks is that? Simple subtraction. And you'll just build until you feel your tower is complete. So it's really that simple. Engineers do a lot of problem solving on the job, so it's a great way if you're building with blocks that can be knocked over, like wooden blocks, and maybe you're really, really trying to get your tower as high as you can and it falls. Well, that's a time to say, maybe I need to think about how the bottom of my tower looked. What shape might I need instead of the one I used? Just keep experimenting, have fun, ask questions, and I hope I'll see you again. Bye.